All right, welcome back to the channel. My name is Lian Duan. I have been a developer over 20 years. I focus on DevOps and the security of cloud. Today I'll demo how to run GitLab pipeline to continuously deploy Docker container to AWS ECS Fargate service. The video read markdown file and the .gitlab-ci.yaml file are in my GitLab. The links are below. Let's start. Topics is manually update Docker container to AWS ECS Fargate steps. How to use pipeline to continuously deploy Docker container to AWS ECS Fargate service. Hands-on demo, deploy Docker container to AWS ECS Fargate service. Clean up AWS resources. First topic is manual update Docker container to AWS ECS Fargate steps. There are three steps can reach the goal. First step, build Docker image. Second step, create a Fargate task definition with existing task name. Third step, update existing Fargate service. Next topic, how to convert the manual steps to GitLab pipeline. Continuous deploy code in the deploy stage. The state has two tasks. Task 1 is create a new task definition with the existing task definition name. Task 2 is update an existing service. There are two ways can do the tasks. Run Amazon command line interface in deploy stage or create deploy state based on the GitLab template. AWS command line interface way is simple and good to start. The GitLab template is more powerful, but it needs a paid plan in GitLab. AWS command line interface is used in my today's demo. We move to the next topic, hands-on demo, deploy Docker container to AWS ECS Fargate service. First, overview target AWS ECS Fargate service as below chart. This is high-level network traffic workflow. First, user traffic go to Route 53 via application load balancer DNS name. Second, Route 53 routing traffic to application load balancer on port 80. Next, the application load balancer forwards traffic to a Fargate demo service instance. I will create a pipeline that builds a new version Docker image. Create a new version of demo app task definition. Upgrade demo service to the new demo app task definition version. The pipeline needs three variables. I'll show how to get and add them in GitLab UI. Move to next slide. Add pipeline variables. First question, where we can find the AWS access key ID and AWS secret access key. Go to the AWS page, we can find them. Login as root user, select root user, put root user email. Input the password, sign in. Go to the right top corner, select account area. Move to security credentials, select access keys. Create a new access key, click show access key. There's two variables, copy and save them to save place. Second question, how to add the keys to the GitLab? Open GitLab web page. Select Projects Rewrite UI app. The app used in my demo. Select Settings. Click CI/CD side menu. Move to Variables area. To save our time, the three keys are added. You see the AWS Access Key ID and AWS Secured Access Key. Use option Masked to avoid the value print in the GitLab log. Click Edit button to open the AWS default region. The value is US-East-1 because AWS always release new version service on the region. After the three values are added, switch back to my slide. Move to next slide, CI/CD pipeline. The pipeline has five states. It can build React UI app and create a Docker image based on the React UI app and push the Docker image to my Docker Hub public repository. Finally, upgrade the Docker image to AWS EC2 Fargate service. The video, How to Use Artifacts in GitLab Pipeline, has init, build, test, and publish state detail. The link is below. The deploy state detail in the next slide. Let me move to deploy state has three parts. The first part has install AWS command line interface and configure login credentials. In the second part, read a JSON file to a variable. The JSON file content is task definition. The third part, to run AWS commands to create a new version of task definition and upgrade the target service. I put two commands official document links are below. If you are interested in the parameters of two commands, open the link and check them. When you do exercise, please change the execution role of Amazon resource names to your ARN. The ARN can find in the role of IAM. Move to next slide for task definition. Usually I run the AWS ECS describe task definition command to get the task definition JSON file and save it as template based on the requirement to change the item in the template. For my hands-on demo, only the version tag is changed from V8 to V9. Next slide is to-do list in my demo. I'll create an application load balancer, create a target service. To save our time, I will reuse the target group and the Fargate cluster. The video, How to Create an Application Load Balancer with AWS ECS Fargate, has a step-by-step demo to create them and then verify the Fargate service. We should see version number 8 in the UI. Next, I'll change and trigger a GitLab pipeline to rebuild React App Docker image and push it to Docker Hub. Also update the task definition and service. Final step, verify the update Fargate service. We will see the version 9 in the UI. Let me switch to the AWS page. Select EC2. Move down to load balancer. Create a load balancer. The load balancer type is application load balancer. Name is demo Fargate application load balancer. Network in two regions, US East 1A and US East 1B. Reuse existing security group. Delete default one. Reuse existing target group. Create a load balancer. Create in progress. And then go to Electrical Container Service. Collect task definition. Select demo app task. Select demo app task version 36. Image version is React App UI V8. I believe we can reuse the task definition. Go to left navigation menu, click clusters, open demo Fargate cluster. Under the service tab, select create button. Launch type is Fargate. Service name, demo service. Number of tasks is 2. Go next. Cluster VPC, use default one. Subnet, select US East 1A and US East 1B. Security group, use existing one. Select existing security group. Use demo service security group. Save. Load balancer type is application load balancer. Add to load balancer. Port is 80. Target group name, demo Fargate, ALB target group. Next step, ignore service auto scaling. I will create a separate video for all detail. Next step, create a service. View service. Two tasks in provisioning. Started change to pending. Next started should be running. Refresh the page. It's running right now. Back to EC2 service. Go to load balances. Copy the demo Fargate application load balancer DNS name. Paste to the address bar. The UI is rendered. The UI version is V8. Since there is not backend microservice deployed, the backend API version is loading, status is write behavior. Change and trigger the GitLab pipeline. Open my local React UI app project. Move to the source code folder. Select components, open the version folder, open the index.gsx file, change the UI version from V8 to V9, and go to the task-definition.json file, go to the task_definitions.json file, change the image version from the V8 to V9. Finally, go to the .gitlab-ci.yaml file, change the build docker image version parameter from V8 to V9. Let me commit my code to trigger the pipeline. Commit my change. Change to V9. Commit. Synchronize change. Okay. Check the pipeline status. Open the latest one. Pipeline build in progress. File status are completed. Final step, verify the update Fargate service. Let me back to the AWS to check the upgrade status. Sign in as root user. Select EC2 services. Go to target groups. Select demo target application load balancer target group. You see there's 4 instances because 2 of 4 instances is old version run with the Docker image version V8. Other 2 instances are running the V9. Rolling upgrade process take time. Refresh the page. You see the 2 V8 version Docker image instances are draining right now. Go to load balancers, copy the DNS name, try verify the status, still in the V8. Refresh. UI version is changed from V8 to V9. Latest and important topic for today, clean up AWS resources. If we do not do it, AWS will charge our money, even though our account is in the free tier. There are 2 steps, delete application load balancer and the Fargate service. Select the demo Fargate application load balancer. Click actions menu, select delete. Yes, delete. Next, go to Elytra container service. Click demo Fargate cluster. Select demo service. Click delete. Delete me. Delete. Delete tasks which are created by target group. Select stop the task. The tasks start by automatic process. Stop. All topics are completed. Today we learned run GitLab pipeline to continuous deploy Docker container to AWS ECS Fargate. Thank you and see you in the next video.